A very warm welcome to all our young viewers at home.
I'm Neville and this is my wife Carol.
And we are here to take you on this fantastic, marvelous, informative journey through the stories of the Holy Bible itself. And before we take you on this journey, this particular journey of how Jacob returned to the land of Canaan, we will make the sign of the cross.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
So this story is about a wrestling match. Do you like wrestling? Do you like WWE or something like that? I don't know if it still exists.
Of course it is.
Okay. Everybody loves a little bit of wrestling, I guess, to watch wrestling at least. So I'll tell you about this interesting wrestling match that happens with Jacob. Jacob, as you know, early in the morning was leaving to go back to the promised land of Canaan. As he was approaching this land, he began to think of his brother Esau, whom he had tricked many years ago and taken away the elder son's rights and blessings from Esau through tricking his father Isaac. Now, would Esau still be angry with me after all these years? Jacob thought. Will he forgive me when he sees me? He also thought. Or will he just kill me for the wrong that I have done? With all these confusing thoughts and doubts in his mind, Jacob sent a few of his servants ahead of him to inform Esau that his brother Jacob is now returning to Canaan. The servants returned back to Jacob, telling him that Esau is getting an army of 400 men ready to come with him. And they think that Esau will destroy Jacob and everything that he possesses. Jacob now made a plan. He divided his flock, the milk camels, its young ones, the goats, the sheep, everything that he owned, he made a set of those to be gifted to his brother Esau. He put one servant in charge of the different herds and asked the servants to go ahead of them and to say exactly these words to Esau. Master Esau, your servant Jacob wants to present to you these flock. Jacob himself is just behind us. He will reach shortly. Jacob thought that by giving gifts, by giving this present, he will be able to win over his brother's favor and forgiveness. On the other hand, as this flock and the servants went this way, Jacob took his wives, their maids, and the 11 sons that he had and crossed the river by evening time. He himself stayed back a little because he wanted to spend this time in prayer all night. So the wife and the kids went ahead and Jacob stayed by himself. He prayed and prayed to God. That night, he said to God, he reminded God, in fact, of the promise that God had made to protect him. He first humbled himself and said, God, when I crossed this way 14 years ago, I had nothing but just a walking stick with me. And here I am, so greatly blessed with all these riches, with the number of cattle, with the number of flock, with my wives, with my sons. I am a rich man today, but I do not deserve any of your kindness and generosity. Yet you have kept your word. Save me also, God, from my brother Esau's anger. Just as Jacob was praying this, a stranger appeared and began wrestling with Jacob. This wrestling match between Jacob and this stranger went on for hours and hours, and just before daybreak, when the stranger realized that Jacob won't give up, he struck Jacob at the hip. Thereby, his hip joint came off. Jacob fell to the ground and he could wrestle no more, but he clung on to the stranger. He would not let the stranger go, because Jacob had realized that this was no ordinary man. He begged, he pleaded, and he asked the stranger for a blessing. Now look at Jacob's qualities. He is always fighting for things. He's getting what is his through his perseverance. The stranger asked Jacob, "What is your name?" Jacob, of course, told him his name. To which the stranger said, "Not anymore. Your name henceforth will be Israel." This name means one who strives and perseveres. You, Jacob, have persevered in your struggle against God and against other people. You have held on to God's promises through thick and thin and won your battle. Now you tell me your name, Jacob told the stranger. Why do you want to know my name? Said the stranger and disappeared as the sun shone brightly and it became morning. Jacob realized that once again he had met God. He exclaimed in pure joy, "I have seen God face to face and yet I am alive." Jacob went on limping as his hip was out of the joint, remember? And do you know a fun fact, Neville, about this? Till this date, the descendants of Israel, descendants of Jacob, do not eat the muscle which is at the hip joint whenever they eat any meat. And this is why, because this is the muscle that was struck on Jacob's body.
So this
is something they follow even to this date. So children, you know now who is Israel. Up till now, we knew that the promised land was called Canaan. And we know the country Israel as well. And we know and we've heard through the Mass and through our faith and through the Holy Bible that Israel is God's beloved. You know today whose name is Israel. You and I and Neville, each one of us can be Israel. If we persevere, if we stay strong and hold on to God's promises through thick and thin. So I have just one question for you today. Are you ready to be God's Israel?